Hey everyone, welcome to another VCT predictions video. Today I'm going to be doing both the Pacific and America's League. I would have done these earlier in the week, but I was sick and I'm still kind of recovering, but I'm definitely feeling good enough to record. So I'm going to do that today. So yeah, if you guys enjoy, make sure to leave a like and subscribe. Yeah, let's get right into it. All right, so we're going to start with the Pacific League, where it is the Super Week this week for the last week of the split. And we'll start out with Paper Rex Genji. This one's a pretty easy one for me. I'm going to take Paper Rex. Genji's kind of on a bit of a slide. Last week, people were surprised that Talon beat them. I mean, it was, for me, the easiest upset prediction of all time. It was not even like remotely close in my head. I knew that was going to be. I mean, what was the score of that game? I don't know. I have to go check. I don't really care that much, but still pretty easy upset prediction. And Paper Rex are just a better version of Talon, so I would assume they beat Genji here. And then Zeta T1, I'm gonna take Zeta. I think T1's really overrated based both on their record and just like the public perception of them. They're just super inconsistent. I don't know if it's that they're a gatekeeper team or just week to week they look good or bad. I don't know what it is with them, but they're just not consistent enough to be highly ranked, and I think Zeta is a really good team despite getting beaten by Paper Rex last week. And then I'm actually just gonna do this quickly. DRX is gonna win both their games. They're gonna go 9-0. Not too difficult. Global Detonation. Global should win this game. If they don't, they don't deserve to make playoffs. Oh, and then Talon RRQ. RRQ looked better than I thought last week. But I'm still going to take Talon here. I'm actually really high up on this team, despite them starting really bad. I think the last 3 weeks, was it? Yeah, they beat Zeta, and then they put up a really good fight against Paper Rex, and then they beat Gen G. I think they're going to win this game against RRQ. And maybe have a shot at playoffs. I think they still do. Yeah. There's a scenario where I think if RRQ win both games, and, or not RRQ, if Talon win both games and Gen G lose both games, then Gen G are out and Talon is in the playoffs, which is kind of crazy, but I think it's right at the moment. And then Zeta, Gen G. Again, same thing with Gen G. I'm gonna take Zeta here. Zeta have been looking nice lately. Gen G have not. I think there's definitely a chance that this backfires and Gen G wins this game, but I don't think they're winning this one. Because just because the like amount of prep work for a like super week like this is a little bit different than what it would be for like a normal week like last week. And Global Team Secret, they Team Secret have been bad. That's one bad take I've had with Pacific, like really bad. It was Team Secret at number two at the beginning of the year. I'm gonna be going back and revisiting my power rankings, from the beginning of the split, which should be fun. But yeah, we have Talon, Detonation, Talon win this. So right now I have Talon in the playoffs and Gen G out, which should be interesting. And then Paper Rex, ROQ. I'm going to take Paper Rex in a pretty clean game from them. And then onto the power rankings, where we're going to start at the bottom. Detonation Gaming, staying there. But I don't think they're in a tier of their own at the bottom, despite that being the case in some other regions. I think Team Secret has also been really bad. I mean, they started out. What was it? Let's see. Jeez. Yeah, they started out 2-0, lost to Gen G. Thought, okay, yeah, that's fair. I thought this was a pretty close game, right? Yeah, 13-11 on Fracture. And then surprisingly lost RRQ, even though they were looking good. Detonation, they rolled them, as every team has. They lost to Zeta and then to T1 last week. It's been kind of a downhill roll for Team Secret. I hesitated to move them all the way down here until last week, where I moved them down to 9, and they're going to stay there. Global moving down one after losing to RRQ. I just thought RRQ should be ahead of them. Pretty simple. Talon's still at 6. I'm not gonna overreact to too much, even though they have been looking really good. I think if they, I mean, they'll end up being in the top four, I think, if they make playoffs, for me. And then T1 at five, I think they're nothing but a gatekeeper team right now. Even if you even want to say that, you could just say that they're inconsistent. And then Gen G, I'm not going to overreact to losses. Like, I mean, I'll overreact in my predictions, but I'm not going to overreact to the power rankings. And then Zeta moving up to three, I think it's deserved. But a tier break up to Paper Rex in their own tier at two, and then DRX in their own tier at one. So overall, not too much movement this week, but still, I think these are pretty decent power rankings, but they could very much change over the Super Week. All right, and I took a little break, but now I'm on to Americas, where we have Furia. 100 Thieves is the first game. 100 Thieves last week, they got owned on Ascent by Loud, but actually made it pretty close on Split. Something that Furia did not manage to do against Loud. But Furia looking a lot better than last week, or than the weeks prior, and kind of just having all of their individuals pop off versus NRG, which has been a problem for 100 Thieves in the past. They've just had a player or two just go absolutely nuclear on them a bunch of times that it seems like it should be, or that, like, it's becoming a pattern now. So I'm gonna have Furia taking this one. Despite me thinking they're a little bit overrated, I also don't really believe in 100 Thieves at this point. Oh, jeez, still sick, as you can tell. EG, MIBR. I'm gonna take EG. MIBR have been really bad as of late. I think really bad might be an understatement, but I think you get the point. Then Crew, Sentinels. 10's coming back this week for Sentinels, replacing Def. And I think Saucy's gonna IGL now. And in Saucy's first week as the IGL, I'm gonna take Crew here. And they get their first win against Sentinels. And then NRG Loud. El Clasico in the Americas League and just Valorant in general. This is the best matchup in any region throughout the whole year. And I'm gonna take NRG to win this one over Loud. Loud have been doing some trolling. And even when they're playing at their best, if NRG is playing at their best, I think NRG can go toe to toe with Loud. And I think they'll probably take the first map. If Loud's doing maybe a little bit of trolling. And then they'll figure out a way to win on one of the other two. Then Leviathan, Cloud9. This one, I thought this one was gonna be tough like a few weeks ago, but there's no way I'm not picking Cloud9. Still the best NA team, even over NRG. They've surprised me so much. Even though I did have them power ranked to 8th, which was higher than a lot of people had them, and I said to look out for this team and to trust NCE scouting, but that was more of like a they could be a sneaky playoff team rather than maybe the best team in the league. So, I mean, Leaf, Zeppa, Zelsys, insane job. Rooney and Jake just adapting so well to the new like tier one environment. Good for Cloud9, man. And then now for the last part of the video, we have the Americas power rankings, and we'll start at the bottom with this like big crop of teams, MIBR, Crew, Sentinels, 100 Thieves, and EG. I think you could argue that Sentinels, 100 Thieves, EG should be in their own tier above Crew and MIBR, but I have Crew beating Sentinels this week, and I still think Sentinels can take games off EG and 100 Thieves. I still think 100 Thieves can take games off all these teams. So that's why they're all in the same tier, and even MIBR, I think, could realistically beat one of 100 Thieves or EG going into that final week, or this week and next week. So very big crop of teams, but EG is moving up two spots into the sixth spot. 100 Thieves and Sentinels both losing this week, I think it was. Or Sentinels, or one of them looking bad. Oh no, yeah, 100 Thieves lose to Loud. Sentinels lose to, and Sentinels losing to EG. I still think Sentinels is worse than 100 Thieves. Not by a ton, obviously, but I don't know. I don't think that week one game is really indicative of how good of the team either of them are at the moment. And then Leviathan and Furia in their own tier. I originally, like just before I started recording this, I had Furia at 5 and Leviathan at 4. But I know Leviathan looked good against Crew last week. But other than that, they have not been very good lately. And I still think, I probably think they should have been at 5 the week prior. But that's neither here nor there. But I do think Furia is a better team than them right now. They played really, really well against NRG despite losing. I don't think their like game plans or anything are like anything special, but their individuals are crazy at times, especially Digizen. I mean, they were just unbind on the attack side. They were just kind of running it up short and just shitting on NRG, which kind of led to that 9-3 half, but then NRG was able to play a little bit more around them on their attacking side, and they came back. And then NRG and Loud, the top two NA teams at the 2 and 3. NRG has been one of my best takes of the season so far. I've had them no lower than 3 all year, even when they had the role issues. I just trusted these teams to figure it out, and they have. But I still don't think they're better than Cloud9, who, oh my, I mean, again, just they've been such a pleasant surprise. I did believe in this team a little bit, but definitely more than other people, but I did not think they would get this far. And then Loud staying put in their tier their own at 1. I just think there's no way you can say it's anything else. And yeah, with that, that's gonna be the video. If you guys enjoyed, make sure to leave a like, subscribe, all that kind of stuff. And yeah, I'll see you in the next one. Peace.